Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, wassalatu wassalamu ala Sayyid al-Anbiya'i wal-Mursaleen, amma ba'd. My respected brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today I want to talk about adab and etiquettes towards our parents and our neighbors in Islam. Our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left us with two beautiful things, the Holy Quran and his Sunnah. Our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam always had the best manners and always spoke the best words, whether he was speaking to a large group or to an individual. It is narrated in Sahih al-Bukhari that our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "The best among you are those who have the best character and who have the best manners." Now, how do we go on to practice good manners in our daily lives? This is much easier than you would think. Starting with controlling one's emotions, mainly anger. If you get hot-tempered or agitated by others easily, then either you avoid such company or stay in two possible conditions. The first being a state of fasting, the second being a state of wudu, which is much easier. Now, this does not get rid of your anger, but it will significantly reduce its effect on you by the will of Allah. The second step is to keep oneself in check and to be aware of one's surrounding. If you are lying down and your parents enter the room, quickly get up and say salam to them. If you are lying down and they enter your presence and you have the only available chair, quickly get up and offer them to sit in your place. The best two examples we are taught is that of a bird that's flying in the air and comes to land on the ground. Meaning that when our parents enter our presence or we enter their presence, we should quickly adjust ourselves, sit upright in a proper and respectable manner, just like a bird that puts its wings back into itself. The second example we are taught is that of a slave. If a slave runs off, gets caught, and dragged back to its owner, what would that slave be feeling? He would be extremely humble and respectful because he knows he is at the mercy of the one in front of him. Meaning, the point is that when we come to our parents, no matter how successful we become, we need to come to them humble and as their respectable children. The second and final thing we need to be aware of is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Isra, "And your Lord has decreed that you worship none but Him, and that you be dutiful to your parents. And if one of them, or both of them, attain old age in your life, say not a word of disrespect, nor shout at them, but address them in terms of honor and respect." Meaning that if one of your parents, or both of them, attain old age, treat them with respect and kindness. If they call you, then quickly answer them with a smile. Do not lie down and yell across the room just so you won't have to get up. The next thing is to be extremely, extremely kind to them. Meaning you do not raise your voice over theirs. Coming back to our neighbors, what has Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said and mentioned about our neighbors? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah An-Nisa, "Worship Allah and associate nothing with Him. And to parents do good, and to relatives, orphans, the needy, the neighbors, the near neighbors, the neighbors further away, the companions at your side, the travelers, and those whom your right hand possess. Indeed, Allah does not like those who are self-deluding and boastful." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to treat parents good, and in the same sentence, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned neighbors. That's how much importance we need to give to them. But the main question that comes to mind is, why do we have to strengthen this bond? Our Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said in Sahih al-Bukhari that by Allah he is not a believer. By Allah he is not a believer. By Allah he is not a believer. He said this three times. So the companions, the Sahaba asked, "Ya Rasulullah, who?" He sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "The one whose neighbor does not feel safe from his evil." In another narration in Sahih al-Bukhari, our Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that the angel Jibreel alayhi salam came to him and kept recommending him to treat his neighbors well to such an extent that he thought he would be instructed to make them his heirs. Meaning that the angel Jibreel alayhi salam came to our beloved Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam and put so much importance on treating the neighbors well to such an extent that our Prophet ﷺ thought that he would have to give his inheritance to them. That's how much respect we need to give to our neighbors. And that's how well we need to treat our neighbors. Now, anything I say first applies to me and then to you. So what are some things that we can do to actually attain the respect of our neighbors and the respect and love of his messenger, our messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Firstly, the main thing we need to do is treat our neighbors good and to not cause them harm in any way. Meaning, if you see that they need help, then go and offer your assistance to them. If they fall ill, if your neighbors fall ill, then go and help them, visit them. If they are met with good fortune, meaning if something good happens to them, then go and congratulate them. Finally, if you bring home something, if you buy and bring home food or anything of that sort to your home, then share it with them. And if you cannot share it with them, then do not throw your garbage away in front of them so they see what you had. This is because you don't want them to feel bad in any way, saying that so-and-so ate this or did this without me. Now, it is a small step that will require some confidence. But since our niyyah, our intention, is for the sake of Allah, then not even shaitan, the devil, can get in our way. With that, say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim and go and greet your neighbors. If they are not busy, quickly knock or ring the bell once and say, "Hi, I was in the neighborhood and just thought I should come and greet you." If they continue, then from this point you can continue and say, "If you need my help, then please let me know, I'm available." Now, it is a small step, but a necessary one we have to take. This can strengthen our community and increase the love and bond we share with one another. Pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helps us perfect our good habits and help us avoid wasting time. Ameen. If I said anything good or true, it is a gift from Allah Azza wa Jal. If I made any mistakes, they are certainly my own. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.